Of course, you know who Hilton is.
Jared off the front, setting the pace for the market. Local rider.
Thank you.
kids in their bottles.
Thank you.
Thank you. Another group joins. Alzate in that group.
Thank you.
just to put it in words, imagine being tossed.
Thank you.
Arrogant Boulevard.
He's not going to lap the field faster than any breakaway that's gone around.
Thank you. Oh!
which will be punctured at a pop up. Here's the front.
Taco, we're going to be entering. I Thank you.
Stephen Hall being driven by the quietest crowd in the history.
Late. Mark the right guy to follow. go, but then.
So they're going to stop it. They have to be ready for the second split.
Yeah, I think they're going to just pull. They got four guys. They can do a train.
Thank you.
I can't believe he did it. Thank you.
the field. Thank you. 5.
Thank you.
Cycle on the front. Trying to organize for their sprint. Right now, Jake Keo is the main speaker.
for Adam here.
Thank you.
to do. I don't know. Is it shit back there? Do you need, to start moving up? Alright, then we'll start moving up then if you want. You want it inside or outside? Right? Don't let those guys go. ahead? Okay.
Shoulder, waiting to see who's going to come over him. So Silent still controlling it as they've done for a long time. At least 20 laps Silent has been riding on the front right now. United Healthcare, look at the long train like that. This becomes difficult in itself because there's so many riders, it makes such a long distance for anyone to be able to move up. Estella's really is going to have to think about starting to move up, try to get in between that United Healthcare train. They're going to have to break it up a little bit, I think.
Yeah, I cannot wait to see what United Healthcare does about this. The question is, has Cylance gone too early here? Because they've been controlling since about 10 laps to go. We saw them go to the front. Remember, they've got two riders a lap up in this group, as that's going to be Orlando Garibay wearing number 4 and Andres Diaz wearing number 7. But United Healthcare's got 4 a lap up, and they haven't been on the front all day long today. I'm liking United Healthcare more and more as this one goes on.
Well, last year, United Healthcare won this race. As a reminder, Ryan Aitchison was 2nd. He's one of the riders vying for the win right now. And Bobby Lee was 3rd. So the riders that were in 2nd, 3rd at this race last year are part of the riders that lapped the field, and they're in this main group. So we're seeing 2 laps to go as we're waiting for when they come around. We're going to have 2 laps to go right now. Silence on the front. United Healthcare coming over the top right now. This is what we were waiting for. Diaz has to get inside that train.
Yeah, look at the guys trying to get low, trying to duck out of the wind here as they are battling the conditions here in Clarendon. United Healthcare has now taken over on the front, and they've got 5 guys in control. But here comes Estellas just behind them at 2 laps to go.
Diaz getting shuffled to the back. Going to have to find a ticket to try to get a car ride with one of these riders. Estellas, all with their team, is very easily just moving him out of position. So Silence going from the very first position to the 3rd team in position, which means right now he's about 15 riders back. Bobby Lee moving up on the left-hand side with the gray jersey. Diaz in the green. Then you have the red jerseys and the blue and white.
So now it becomes a battle for position. In the final 2 laps of racing, you've got to get inside the top 10. But if you find yourself at the very front of the bike race, you are in the wrong place to win this bike race today. Out of the final turn, onto the finishing stretch, where they will get 1 lap to go. As the crowd continues to cheer on the riders here at the Air Force Association Cycling Classic Clarendon Cup. We're at one lap to go, 1K of racing remaining in Arlington.
Look like Adrian Hegeveri on the front with Alzate in second. Alzate also a very good crit rider. Again, I mentioned, this is the perfect race course to be able to open up a gap. Three riders go flying around. These are riders that were off the front that they're catching right now. United Healthcare diving on the inside. They're going to think if they can keep six or seven riders lined up, when you come into that last corner, you sit up, open up a gap, and see what can happen.
Frankie, I think Astellas is the last team that has a real shot at derailing the blue train today. Silence went way too early. They burned through their guys, and now they've got no one left. There they are, trying to work up. That is Diaz on the front with Garibay sitting just behind him, but I think they are way too far back. Meanwhile, Astellas has their riders up there. Ryan Encheson and Brandon Feary have gone a lap up. On to the finishing stretch.
It's Agenson on the left-hand side in the red, and then it's the blue and white with Ty Magner and Luke Keogh coming to the line.
And Ian Keogh is there as well, but United Healthcare launches the sprint early, and they are going to sweep that one across the line as United Healthcare gets it done with four riders in the break, and that is, I think, Ty Magner getting the sprint win for United Healthcare today.